a community nurse, I wanted to start a movement which would make the healthcare and elderly care in Holland better. We have a lot of bureaucracy, and a lot of bureaucracy which is disturbing good solutions. So that's the reason that I called it humanity above bureaucracy. If you look at what Buurtzorg is at the moment, we can say it's a new organizational and a new delivery model. I started in 2007 with four nurses, with the three colleagues, just in one team, trying to go back to the principles of the World Health Organization on community-based integrated care, which I think is a very good model. At the moment, we have 9,000 nurses and 800 independent teams working all over the country. What's very special is that we have only 45 staff people in the head office, and we have 15 coaches, so we don't have management. And we are serving 70,000 patients a year. We have a turnover of 280 million euro per year, and we have just six people at the financial administration, and we don't have a CFO. So if you keep things very simple, then you don't need so many people to control all these things. In the 90s in Holland, healthcare, and especially community-based care, was defined as production. And we developed 10 different products, which was called personal care extra, personal care special. And we had nursing, nursing care special, nursing care extra, guidance, guidance extra. For a lot of commissioners in Holland, it's the way they buy care. We want to buy so many hours of this and so many hours of that. And it's really disturbing the relationship with patients, between patients and nurses. The costs went right up, so we are the second country in the world with the most expensive healthcare system. And the quality went down. A lot of nurses quit their jobs because they lost their autonomy, and they've lost also their craftsmanship. What I liked a lot about community nursing is that in every situation you can find in some kind of a co-production with the patient what's the best solutions in this situation. When we look at the demographics, and I think it's the same in Great Britain, when we face the coming 20 years, we got a lot of problems with getting enough young people in healthcare. So we should make it more inspirational for young people. Clients, because of these many products, clients were confronted with a lot of different caregivers. So there was one in Amsterdam, and he put all the names on one of the doors in his room. And during 1 year, he got 150 different caregivers and nurses coming at his house. So the idea was independent teams with a maximum of 12 nurses working in a neighborhood for 5,000 to 10,000 inhabitants, and just organize everything themselves. So not thinking about all these different codes and products, but just thinking about what are the best solutions for the patients we are meeting, and doing the assessment themselves, the planning, the scheduling, and so on, and sharing a lot of experience with each other together. The idea of maximum of 12 nurses is that you can coordinate everything together, and you don't need some kind of a leader in a team. They are generalists. They have to be able to take care for all types of patients because they deliver 24 hours a day care. So they organize it, they are available 24 hours a day. We don't have a call center, so they just get all the phone calls themselves and they solve all the things themselves. 50% are bachelor educated nurses. They have their own education budget because they know the best what kind of education they need. The idea is also that informal networks are much stronger than organizational structures. So all these nurses have their networks and have a lot of influence in their environment. This is our vision model. We say we should be part of the community. So every nurse should have her network with volunteers, with the GPs, with the social workers. So informal networks and formal networks, and try to make virtual teams around the patient. Then about quality, what we do is we monitor the outcome based on the Omaha system. So we measure what the effectiveness is of our interventions. We also started with the Buurtzorg Academy. It's an e-learning environment and which all the nurses can use for get educated on different fields. We didn't have one management meeting since we started. So a lot of meetings, my former job were only about meetings, from one meeting to another. And I think now we just have time to solve the problems. Then we build an IT system that supports the nurses in a good way. And the next step is also to involve the patients to be active in this platform. What was very nice to experience was that this IT system also worked as some kind of a Facebook. So I write my blog. I don't write policy notes. I don't write strategic notes. But I share my concerns and then in my blog. And then I got a lot of response from the different teams. And when this response is going some direction, then we say, okay, let's make it a new policy. So that's how to develop policy in a modern way, I think. The teams are working very solistic, so they're focusing on the neighborhood, but because of the platform, they feel like one. They feel part of Buurtzorg, but they don't feel Buurtzorg as an organization who gives them trouble, but only as a network who gives them presence. If you look at the cost effectiveness for the organization, the overhead costs are quite low if you look at compared with other organizations. So you can use the money for higher skilled nurses and for innovation and education. We are a non-for-profit organization, we are a foundation, because our values don't fit in a commercial organization. And that's, I think, for me very important in the discussion about how should we create incentives that create better healthcare. And is competition leading to better healthcare? At the moment, the government is taking our way of working as an example. They're now stimulating other organizations, and also other sectors are quite interested in the model. So I also work with policemen and with teachers, because I think it's a general model which can be used in different sectors. There are three principles. The needing principle, do what's needed. The second is the rethinking principle. Just reflect on what you're doing and try to do it better if you think you're not doing the best you can. And the third principle is the common sensing principle. Use your common sense. I think we have to build organizations on meaningful relationships. So I think that, especially in healthcare, it is about trustful relationships. That is the best, I think, condition for good healthcare. Then we should think about, as an organization, what's the value for the community? Not what's the commercial value for the organization. I think organizations should be financially healthy, but they should think about what their value is for the community. I think we should focus more on happiness and health. I think that when nurses in our organization feel happy, they will stay healthy and they will do good things. And last conclusion is, let's avoid complexity. So we build very complex organizations, and even if we are with 9,000 people, it can be a very simple organization. So try to focus on craftsmanship and on simple organizations, and then the complexity is in the work itself.